In the previous video, I had shown you how using fputc you can write one character at a time to a file on a disk. In this particular program, I'll show you how you can read one character at a time from the file we had written in the previous program. So if you remember the name of the file in the previous program, it was 1_char_write.txt. The difference is I'm opening this file in read mode because I want to read one character at a time. Then first thing I'm checking is whether opening this file there is any error. If it is no error, then I'm going to continue in my loop. So what I'm doing in my loop is I am using a function called fgetc. The only parameter to fgetc is the input stream. The input stream is represented by fptr, which represents this particular file on the hard disk. So using fptr to fgetc, I am reading character by character. The ASCII value of that character is assigned to I. And as long as I have not reached end of the file, I am continuing to read one character at a time. As I read a character using %c and I am printing that character on the screen. This thing will be clear once you take a look at the demo being shown along with this particular video, which immediately follows this particular video. So please take a look at the demo. The demo will get you clear about how fgetc is working. It is very similar to getchar, except that it is getting from the file. And it will keep getting and returning an integer value equal to the ASCII value of the character read. The minute it reaches end of the file, it will come out and then we are required to close the file. If you want to take a look at the prototype of fgetc, quite simple. Fgetc has only one prototype. It is file star stream. Stream indicates source of input. In this case, stream is fptr. Fptr happens to be your file. So what happens is fgets reads one character at a time, returns the ASCII value of that particular character as an integer. If it reaches end of the file, it will return end of the file, or if it encounters error, it will return a EOF value. So if it returns a EOF value, that means it has reached end of the file or some error has happened. So this should help you understand how you read one character at a time from a file.